My next painting will be on canvas, and I don't work on canvas very often, but if you've watched any of my other videos, you'll probably know that I like to work on a very smooth surface. This particular canvas is relatively smooth to begin with, but it's not quite as smooth as I would like. So in this video, I'll show you guys how I prep a canvas before I begin painting on it. So when I'm prepping a canvas for paint, all I'm using is acrylic gesso. And normally I will spray it onto the canvas with a full-size spray gun. For whatever reason, when I explain this process to a lot of people, they don't realize that you can reduce your gesso with water. I never use tap water. I always use distilled or deionized water because I don't want to introduce impurities into the surface before I even begin the painting process. But you can reduce it with water in order to spray it through a full-size spray gun. So what I normally do is spray one or two coats, allow that to dry, then I'll come in and sand lightly, followed by another one or two coats of gesso, followed by sanding, and so on and so forth until I'm happy with how smooth the texture is. Now I realize a lot of you guys may not be able to afford a full-size compressor large enough to run a full-size spray gun. So in this video, I'm going to show you guys a manual method for doing this. There's pretty much two methods that you can use. You can use a paintbrush to apply the gesso onto the surface. I don't like the paintbrush just because it's going to leave a lot more texture in the finish with the brush strokes, and that requires more work to sand out. What I personally prefer to do is use a body filler spreader. And all I'll do is pour a little bit of this gesso onto the canvas and begin spreading it out. And you want to try to get this as evenly as you possibly can. You want to create less work for the sanding process that comes after this cures. All I'm doing here is just trying to get the gesso spread over the entire canvas. And then I'll lightly go over in order to remove some of these ridges that I've left with the spreader. Is a little bit bowed, I think. So sometimes with your Bondo spreader, it will work better on one side than it does on the other. At this point, I'm barely dragging it over the surface. It's somewhat difficult to get it all even, which is why I normally prefer to spray it. This will get the job done. It just takes a little bit more patience. And I'll be putting more layers on here, so it's not necessary to get it perfectly smooth the first one or two coats that you put down. But for the edges, you don't want a big buildup of gesso on the side. So I'll normally just run my finger along the sides and get that smoothed out as well. And then you can take the spreader and spread out what you just pushed off the end. Notice how I'm wiping the spreader off now that I'm doing the edges so that I don't keep building another edge. I think that's good for the start. Give this some time to dry and then we'll come back for the next step. Okay, this has had plenty of time to dry now, so we can move on to the sanding part of the process. One thing to mention, if you're doing this by hand, meaning when you're putting the gesso on your canvas, if you're using a hairy paintbrush or even a body filler spreader, you will leave some streaks and some little uneven areas on your canvas. It's just inevitable. It requires more work sanding it back down flat than it does compared to spraying it on with a spray gun. At the end of the video, I'll share another product that you can use if you don't have access to a spray gun. But the next part of this process is to sand this down. I use a soft block when I do this, and I start with 320 grit sandpaper. I'll use the 320 grit until I pretty much get the canvas to the point that I'm ready to paint on it. Then I'll usually put one more coat of gesso on and then sand that with 600 grit. Now when you're sanding this, be very careful. As we all know, a canvas has a wood frame on the inside of it. And depending on how large your canvas is, you might have cross braces going across too. So if you start sanding this and apply a lot of pressure, the canvas stretches and it will fall down and you'll wind up with the ridge or low spot all the way around where the wood frame is underneath the canvas. So it takes very light pressure and you don't want to sand too much. This isn't primer, this isn't a super thick coat. So you can sand through the cotton fibers of the canvas if you're not careful. So I'm just gonna lightly go over it. I think that's probably good. I don't want to get too carried away because the coats of gesso that we're putting on this canvas are very thin. So I'll clean this off and then we'll start putting another coat of gesso on. I'm just going to use a little bit of Windex to wipe this sanding dust off. And this is the exact same process as what we did before. I'm just going to add another light layer of gesso to the canvas, and then I'll spread it out with my body filler spreader. Again, trying to keep it as even and smooth as possible. I think that looks pretty good. Don't forget to clean up the sides and the edge. And we'll give this some time to dry again before we sand it. So I went ahead and sanded the second coat of the gesso down with the 320 grit sandpaper off camera because you guys have already seen the process. Everything that you've watched up to this point has been in real time. I haven't cut or edited anything out. And that's all it takes. So in all, I probably got maybe 15, 20 minutes invested in this canvas at this point. And I'm pretty happy with how smooth it is after just the two coats. You can layer as many coats of gesso and sand in between as you want. And some canvases, depending on how thick the texture is, will require a few more coats. But this one is doing pretty good. Now, the reason I use 320 grit sandpaper is because it's relatively aggressive. It cuts down the gesso quickly in the first initial stages. However, coming from an automotive background, 320 grit, as I said, is still relatively aggressive. There's a chance if you go ahead and paint over this canvas as it sits now that you will see some sand scratches in your artwork. I don't want that. That's why I generally go to 600 grit before I actually start airbrushing my artwork onto the canvas. So you could take your body filler spreader and lay another coat of gesso down. The problem with that is it takes longer and more work to cut down all the little ridges and uneven areas that you'll get with a body filler spreader with 600 grit versus 320 grit. So what I was talking about earlier is the Krylon aerosol gesso. This stuff, I'm ordinarily not a big fan of anything rattle cam, but this stuff works really well. So if you don't have access to a full-size spray gun or the equipment to spray your gesso onto your canvas, this is a great alternative. Now, I don't recommend that you spray the aerosol gesso for every coat to this point. It's not a high build. It's not like a high build primer where you're going to get a lot of coverage. It'll go on even thinner than what we spread on with the body filler spreader. So this is what I use towards the end. Now that this canvas is almost pretty much where I want it before I'm going to start painting on it, I'll put one or two coats of the aerosol gesso on. So you want to make sure that you shake the can up well before you apply it. And like I said, I'll probably put just one or two coats on this canvas and I think we'll be good to go. So I've allowed this to dry overnight and the aerosol gesso has filled in the previous sand scratches left behind by the 320 grit sandpaper. We now have a super smooth surface with the exception of a few little dust nibs here and there to paint on. In reality, you could go ahead and paint on this as it sits, especially if you're not planning on using any masking techniques in your work. Personally, I prefer to put just a slight bit of a tooth into my canvas before I begin painting. That way I know that I will not have any delamination issues later on down the road. Not to mention the fact that there are a few just little dust nibs in here. I can't stress enough that you want to use a very light touch when you're sanding this. Again, I'll be using 600 grit sandpaper for this step because it's the end. And one thing that I don't necessarily like about the aerosol gesso is you might notice it's a little bit of an off-white color. Again, if you have access to a spray gun, I would much prefer to use the spray gun to spray my last coat using the same gesso that we used previously versus the aerosol if I have that option. Another option is you can spray an Autoborn sealer on here versus the gesso. I normally use gesso as opposed to the Autoborn sealer just because it's a little bit less expensive. So at this point, I'll go ahead and lightly scuff over this. And then we'll go from there. There you go, guys. That's my solution to prepping out a canvas before I begin my airbrush artwork. Now, can you take this same canvas straight out of the package without doing any of this work and airbrush your artwork onto it? You bet you can. And in rare instances, I will actually do that because I want to take advantage of the pre-existing texture on the canvas in my artwork. But the vast majority of the time, I prefer to work on a very super smooth, texture-free surface. Can you buy a canvas that's already super smooth and ready to be painted on? You can, but they're harder to find and they're generally more expensive. As you saw in the video, this requires a little bit of effort to get it to this point, but it's really not that much work in the grand scheme of things, and it doesn't require a large investment in tools or equipment. So it's just an option, guys. It's what I like, it's what I prefer. Your preference may be something totally different. So that pretty much wraps up this video. I'll leave some links to some of these products in the description below. I hope you guys got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share, and I'll see you guys next time.